The Marcos administration bears more key appointments, and the president vetoes a bill seeking more powers for the Government Corporate Council. Our correspondent Katrina Domingo is on the line for more details. Katrina, go ahead.
Hi, Rain. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. has vetoed Senate Bill 2490 and House Bill 9088, which seeks to strengthen the office of the Government Corporate Council by rationalizing and further professionalizing its organization. In his veto message, Marcos says that he finds many of its provisions overbearing, specifically the excessive grant of remuneration, incentives, benefits, and allowances, saying that these violate the principles of equity and standardization. You see, Rain, the OGCC, which is under the jurisdiction of the Department of Justice, is the principal and statutory law office of government-owned and controlled corporations. It is, in fact, under, again, the control of the DOJ. However, the proposal hikes the salary grade of the Government Corporate Council from 30 to 31, and Marcos says that this would effectively put the Government Corporate Council on the same salary level as that of the Secretary of Justice. The president says this would distort the supervisor-subordinate relationship between the two individuals. Marcos also vetoed the same bill, citing the strong opposition of the cabinet's economic managers due to the inequity in compensation and substantial fiscal risks it may bring to the country. Marcos says he is not persuaded that the bill would actually be in line with other existing laws that already govern and supervise these agencies that are involved. Meantime, Rain, as you mentioned earlier, also released this morning are several key appointments by the president. Among these is Sandigan Bayan Justice Alex Quiroz, who is now named as the chairman of the Governance Commission for the government-owned and controlled corporations. Quiroz, if we recall, penned the decision that junked a case at the Sandigan Bayan about the ill-gotten wealth of the Marcos family. Quiroz is earlier told us that he would file an optional retirement as Sandigan Bayan justices are not allowed by the law to actually head another government agency unless they step down or retire from their current posts. Also included in that list of appointees released this morning is the retention of Prospero de Vera as chairperson of the Commission on Higher Education, as well as the appointment of Emmanuel Buenaflor Salamat as the executive director of the National Secretariat of the National Task Force to End Local Communist Armed Conflict. Wayne?
All right, and we're looking at those key appointments right now. Kat Domingo, thank you so much for that update. Agriculture is expected to be among the highlights of President Marcos's first State of the Nation address on Monday. Industry stakeholders share what they believe should be the Marcos administration's top priorities. Lady Vicencio reports.
As to agriculture, I think that the problem is severe enough that I have decided to take on the portfolio of Secretary of Agriculture, at least for now.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr.'s decision to temporarily assume the post of Agriculture Secretary was seen as a welcome move by stakeholders and sectors in agriculture. They now expect him, as both the country's top official and agriculture chief, to personally oversee an industry plagued by high prices and supply disruptions amid a looming food crisis. In the 3 weeks since temporarily assuming the post as agriculture chief, Marcos has held two executive meetings with agriculture officials to discuss the rice tariffication law, increasing food production, and budget allocations. Among Marcos's campaign promises was to bring down the price of 1 kilo rice to 20 pesos. But recently, rice prices went up by 3 pesos per kilo in Metro Manila markets. A kilo now ranges from 38 pesos to 50 pesos. The Samahang Industriya ng Agrikultura says the 20 peso kilo rice is not possible within the year.
Wala pa. Hindi natin makita this year siguro yung pagbaba ng presyo. Dahil mataas ang fuel price, mataas ang inputs, walang masyadong subsidy ang ating government. So wala tayong makitang pagbaba ng presyo. Sa ngayon, dapat habulin yung remaining na hindi pa natanim yung subsidy na hinihintay.
Farmers and fisher folk are also reeling from high fuel prices. The high cost of fuel means higher fertilizer and feed costs, leading to higher prices of livestock and poultry. A kilo of chicken now retails at 210 pesos, while pork ranges from 330 to 380 pesos per kilo.
Pinipilit namin na ma-improve yung performance. Kaya lang, may challenge din pa rin tayo doon sa quality ng feeds. Kailangan ay bigyan ng kumpiyansa yung mga corn farmers, rice farmers na magtanim. Pag nag-anihan at maraming odik at maraming imported, hindi pababayaan yung presyo nila dahil napakalaki na sa palaran nila ngayon. Kung nadaming lahat, ang taas ng puhunan ng mga farmers, lalo na sa pataba, mula 800 to 900, nasa 3,400 na to 3,600.
Chicken and pork supplies still haven't normalized since the outbreaks of the African swine fever and avian influenza. Broiler and layer raisers are still cautious to repopulate with the continuing spread of the diseases. While swine inventory has increased in the first 3 months of the year by 1.2%, or a total of almost 9.7 million heads, only those in commercial farms expanded their inventory. Backyard farms, which account for 70% of the total swine inventory, saw their stocks decline by 0.4%. The Bureau of Animal Industry blames local raisers for this, but various stakeholders point to the lack of first border inspections in ports that have led to the possible entry of infected smuggled meat.
Sa baboy, hanggang ngayon, tuloy-tuloy ang ASF. Ang gusto natin, bayaran ng 10,000 per head ng baboy, 250 pesos. Ang layer na tatamaan ng bird flu. Kasi pag hindi yan nagawa ng paraan, talaga magkakaroon tayo ng malaking problema sa manok, sa itlog, at sa baboy. Hanggat hindi nawawala yung mga smuggler dyan sa DA at saka sa custom, eh kawawa kami mga farmer. Sino ang number one nagpalugi sa manok at sa baboy? Kung bakit tayo naghihirap ngayon sa kamahalan ng baboy? Kaya tayo napasok ng ASF, napasok ng perplo dahil dyan sa smuggling. Wala yung inspeksyon. Inalulusot nila.
The BAI has insured racers they will be compensated.
Indemnification fund po, actually nag-request po tayo ng panibagong amount sa operation. So nag-alaan po sila sa atin ng panibagong amount from the Quick Response Fund ng Department of Agriculture.
For fisher folk group Pamalakaya, government subsidy is long overdue. The group says since March, many have stopped fishing since rising fuel prices are taking up 80% of their production costs. In the first quarter of the year, fishing production has declined by 0.2% or 2,000 metric tons. Supply disruptions due to the war between Ukraine and Russia have led to higher wheat prices, a key ingredient in making bread. Sugar is short in supply after sugar-producing areas in the country were hit by typhoons last year. High fertilizer costs also affected the yield. Data from the Philippine Statistics Authority shows sugarcane production was down 10% in January to March 2022 to 10.46 million metric tons from the 11.63 in the same quarter the previous year. A kilo of sugar now costs 92 pesos per kilo.
Yung sugar order na po, binigay exclusively for the industrials. Doon binagsak lahat ng 4 million bags. Ang suka hindi pumunta sa palengke, pumunta to po sa industrial, yung mga beverage. Yung itong importation dapat, ang makinabang to is consumer para maproteksyonan natin yung ating consumers na hindi sila makabili ng sobrang taas ng asukal.
With so many problems troubling the agriculture sector, stakeholders are waiting on the president's first State of the Nation address. They expect him to lay down concrete plans to address high production and feed costs and competition from cheap imports.
Hintay pa rin ang mga magsasaka. To concentrate on yung production pa rin, hinintay natin. And of course, within 100 days, ma-file yung mga cases against Maggie.
Mahirap pa tasahan kasi in fairness to him, ilan linggo pa lang na wala pa nga isang buwan. Ang pangamba lang namin, ang pinagagalaw pa rin niya, yung mga iniwan na tao ni Secretary Dar, hindi susulong ng production dahil ang paniwala ng mga yan ay ang magbibigay ng seguridad sa atin ay import liberalization.
The agriculture industry hopes for urgent solutions from the president that will help them boost production, bring down prices, and ensure the country's food security. Lady Vicencio, ABS-CBN News.